Welcome to another edition of the Mayor's Minute. I'm here with our outstanding police chief, Steve Anderson, and I'm glad he's joining us today, especially after what we experienced this past weekend. We saw two incidences that highlight the need for us to continue our efforts to reduce crime in Tuscaloosa, which we'll talk about in a second, something we've been pretty successful with. It also highlights the need for you and for us to engage our legislature to help us with what happens after we arrest someone, because that's an important part of the process. Like many of you, I've seen the video on Facebook, and it makes me angry and frustrated and wanting answers of how this could happen in Tuscaloosa. It's important that we begin that search, and one of the ways we can begin that search is understanding what happened, why it happened, and what we can do as a community to address it. So today's Mayor's Minute is going to go a little bit longer, but I think it's needed because we all want answers and we all want to be part of the solution. So let me start by discussing this with our police chief, Steve Anderson. Steve, tell me what happened on the strip in particular last Saturday night.
Well, there was an altercation between two individuals, and that altercation led to one of the individuals retrieving a handgun from a vehicle that was on University Boulevard traveling east, and the individual that retrieved the handgun walked up to the other individual, ran up behind him, and shot him in the back as he was walking off.
Were there officers near the scene when this happened?
Yes, there were a number of officers on the strip in different areas within a block or so of this incident.
Have you seen anything like this in your police career?
Well, we've seen instances before where people have engaged in gun fights or gun play with officers nearby. We saw it at Timmerson 1 year outside of Kennedy's.
Now, when you have experienced this in the past, do you find that this is the first time these individuals have been in trouble with the law?
No, not at all. Usually the individuals that we come in contact with that are involved in gun violence have numerous contacts with us prior to that.
Let's go back to the incident that happened on the strip Saturday night. Those involved in this incident had over 300 interactions with TPD. As someone, although I have this unique experience of working with law enforcement every day, most people do not. And most people that are going to be watching this are going to be wondering, how can somebody or individuals have that much interaction with TPD and still be out on the street causing harm?
You know, it's just a matter of the correction system in our state. There's a problem with corrections, and the problem is that it's an issue of overcrowding. So what the Department of Corrections has tried to do is save the bed space for the most violent people in our communities, and thereby letting other people be out on different things such as community corrections and second chance programs and other alternative sentencing. And so that's one of the reasons why we come in contact with the same individuals over and over again, because there are a lot of individuals that have committed crimes in our community but have not gone off to prison, but have been placed in alternative sentencing programs and allowed to stay in the community, and they're still committing crimes. And these individuals were some of those individuals.
Is it demoralizing to our police officers to arrest and rearrest same individuals?
Yes, it's very demoralizing because the officers that are looking at that, they keep chasing the same people and arresting the same people over and over again. And the officers have a great concern that these individuals are either going to cause serious injury, harm, or death to an individual in the public out at large or to the officers themselves as they repeatedly have contact with them.
Well, I'm going to talk about in a second the challenges that we face within our correction system in addition to the courts and other state functions. The chief, we got a game coming up this weekend against Tennessee, and I know that we've spent a lot of time discussing what we're going to do and some changes that might be taking place. As of Wednesday, what are some of the things that we're thinking about doing to improve safety in and along the strip?
Well, we're going to place some additional officers on the strip to help out with the crowd. We're going to close the strip down between about the Shell station west on University Boulevard to Campus Drive, which is east of the strip area, and only have pedestrian traffic out in that area. And so we're going to prevent the number of vehicles that are allowed to come through that area, and therefore see if we can't get a better handle and control over the crowd that's going to be visiting the area.
And if somebody were concerned about safety, what would you tell them today?
If people are concerned about safety, the best and thing that you can do for us is report crime and report those issues to us. Let us know. Don't wait till things get out of hand before you do something or say something about it. In the situation that we saw in the video that's been sent around on social media, it was interesting that people felt the need to video it so that they could have it to place on social media, but did any of those people call the police department? The first call that we received about the gunfire was when an officer that was nearby heard the shot fired and he radioed in the headquarters. but other people were out there videoing it and watching what was going on, but they failed to do anything about it as far as contacting law enforcement.
So it mirrors what Homeland Security says. If you see something, say something.
Yes, if you see something, say something.
The other thing, though, and I think I want to bust this myth, and a lot of it is, well, crime is out of control in Tuscaloosa, and we certainly see that on social media. But it's not backed up by facts, is it, Chief?
It is not. We have seen a slight increase in our property crimes, things such as burglaries, our unlawful breaking and entering of vehicles and auto thefts. We've seen slight increases in those crimes. But when we look at our homicide numbers, our attempted murder numbers, when we look at the felony assaults, we've seen a decrease in those numbers.
So why do you think people perceive that?
I think that goes back to people are becoming more aware of things that are going on because of social media, and they're more in tune with the violence that's going on, not only here in the city of Tuscaloosa, but on a national level. Every day that we turn on the news or we look at social media, we see some tragic event related to gun violence in this country, and I think people are just more in tune with it.
My last question for you, gun violence does seem to be, especially now with social media, anything that happens instantly is out there for the public to view. But it does seem like there's a proliferation of guns out there. Why do you think we see more guns on the street right now, whether it's factual or not? Why does it feel like there are more guns on the street?
Well, there are more guns on our streets right now. And the reason for that is because we have seen an increase, a significant increase in the number of unlawful breaking and entering of vehicles. And along with that, we've seen an increase in guns being stolen from vehicles. So what we've been doing at the Tuscaloosa Police Department is begging people and pleading with people not to store guns in vehicles. A vehicle is not a secure, safe place to store a handgun. And so we'd like for people to heed that advice and place those guns in a safe environment to keep them out of the hands of our criminals, because criminals are specifically targeting vehicles right now in our city looking for weapons.
Well, I want you to plug real quick before we wrap up. You do something each year where you allow, well, not allow is probably not the right word, where we have citizens come in and actually learn what the police department does. Talk about the Citizens Police Academy real quick, and if someone's interested, how they can learn more information about it.
Yes, we have a Citizens Police Academy with the Tuscaloosa Police Department. We would start accepting applications during the month of December, December 1st through December 31st. We would accept applications, and our first class will begin the first Monday in February. It's an 8-week long program, and it is a program that's designed to bring members of the community into the police department to build relationships, but also to educate the individuals that are part of the Citizens Academy. And destroy a lot of the myths that they have about law enforcement. Now, a lot of those myths that come from watching television shows that are scripted and have a specific purpose, but we want to bring people in to build relationships, educate them, and destroy those myths that they have.
Well, Chief, I'm certainly thankful that you are our chief, that you're taking care of our city. One of the best decisions I think I've made in 12 years was the appointment of Chief Steve Anderson. I know somebody sees it every day. We're very fortunate in Tuscaloosa to have his leadership. I want to close with this. Oftentimes when we have crime in our community, we tend to focus on the police department, but the police department really ultimately responds to symptoms. The bigger issues that we face are education attainment, job opportunity, treating substance abuse problems. That's going to take an entire community to help us eventually if we truly want to reduce crime. And we hope you'll help us be part of that solution through a 501c3, through our HOPE initiative, which engages churches, and outreach throughout Tuscaloosa. So if you're interested in those type of programs, please reach out to Tuscaloosa Police Department or the mayor's office. The last thing, we need your help. The issues that Tuscaloosa Police Department is running into is that we arrest and rearrest the same individuals. And why is that? And as Chief mentioned earlier, our correction system is over 150% of capacity. Our mental health system is collapsing. Pardons and parole is woefully understaffed. And our juvenile detention system, and we didn't even get to that today, is not doing the job that it needs. Those are functions of state government. So when those functions don't work, it creates a scenario where we have an incident take place on the strips where the three primary actors have over 300 interactions with law enforcement. That is not right on any level, and we need your help. So make sure when you talk to your legislator, ask them to make sure they support these programs that support law enforcement. The city will continue doing its job, and we will not stand still, but we need the state to do its job. I appreciate you tuning in to a special edition of the Mayor's Minute. If you have any further questions, please reach out to me. You can contact me at mayor@tuscaloosa.com or @WaltMaddox. And Chief, if they had an email question for you, what's your email address?
SANDERSO@Tuscaloosa.com.
Have a great day. Thank you.